Good morning and welcome to day 7 of our 21-day prayer and devotion. Thank you for tuning in each day, and I'm sure as you open your heart and your mind for God to speak to you, He has been speaking to you and teaching you things that you need for your life. We've been talking about how God is moving us into a new season and how He's already begun a new thing within our lives. Yesterday we talked about how do we maximize the new thing that God is doing within our lives. We talked about the importance of spending time in the presence of God, as it should become our first priority. That is the priority more than anything else. Today we will look at another aspect which will help us to maximize the new thing that God is doing in our lives. Paul, writing to Colossians in chapter 3 verses 1 and 2, this is what he says. Since you have been raised to a new life with Christ, set your sights on the realities of heaven, where Christ sits in the place of honor at God's right hand. Think about the things of heaven, not the things of the earth. Think about the things of the heaven, not the things of the earth. A grandfather was talking to his grandson about the reality of life. He was trying to use an allegory to teach him about what happens in our lives. He says a fight is going inside us. It is a fight between two wolves. One is evil. He's angry. He's jealous. He's greedy and full of pride. The other one is good. He's joyful. He's humble. He's patient, kind, and full of compassion. It's the same within us. The same fight is going on inside you. And inside you, inside every other person too. Listening to grandfather, this boy started pondering over what his grandfather told him and then asked him an interesting question. He said, "Which wolf do you think will win?" And what grandfather said is what we need to think about today. It is this: the one you feed. The one you feed. Out of the two wolves, whichever wolf you feed, that will win eventually. The story is the picture of the constant spiritual battle that goes within the life of each believer. Each day, we fight battles where we either give in to our sinful nature or submit to the leading of the Holy Spirit who is within us. Just like the wolves in the story, the victor is often the one that you and me feed, or we have been feeding in. How then should we feed our spirits? Isn't that what Paul is trying to say? You think about things of heaven, not the things of the earth. So in one sense, he's saying feed into your mind the things of heaven and deprive your mind of the things of the earth. Paul tells us that even as we have been given the new life in Christ, we are to set our hearts and our desires on the things of God, things which concern the heart of God. This means we love the things that God loves, hate the things that God hates. When we begin to do that, and when we begin to feed into our mind things of heaven, things that are approved by God, then our mind starts, winning over all the other one that is deprived of the thoughts. The sinful, evil nature would be defeated by the Spirit-led life. How do we feed that? In Philippians chapter 4, verses 8, Paul gives a beautiful solution. He says, "Finally, my brothers, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any moral excellence, and if there is any praise, dwell on these things." Dwell on this. Think about these things. That's what he's saying. Think about certain kinds of things. That means you're depriving your mind of certain things that will destroy your relationship with God, that will take you away from God, that will stunt your growth, and feed your mind with things that will help you to fight your sinful nature and submit to the leading of the Holy Spirit. Do you find yourself losing in a daily battle and giving in to your spiritual nature? Begin to think on God's word, especially the scriptures that he has quickened in you, quickened to you. Meditate on the word of God. Think about those things. In fact, let me tell you, memorize every word, every verse that you felt God spoke into your heart, and then begin to implement it every single day of your life. And that's how you win every day's battle. In fact, the scriptures will prepare you for the next battle as you win this one. So take time to evaluate your daily routine today. List down the areas in your routine that does not feed into your spiritual nature. List down the areas that are causing immoral behavior, that are causing evil thought process, that are feeding into selfish nature. List of those things, and then make a conscious effort to change that and begin to feed into your mind things that are worthy, praiseworthy, things that are noble, things that will help you to become a better person. Ask God to give you some practical steps in order for you to purposefully grow in your hunger for the things of God. That is my prayer for you. As you spend throughout this day, think on these things. Things that will help you to grow better. And choose to deprive your mind of the things that will take you away from God, and that ultimately lead you to lose your battle. We don't have to be a losers. We are victors if we follow the leading of the Holy Spirit. May God help you as you do this. God bless you.